እንዴት ናችሁ? ይህ ኢትዮ ኤግዚስት ኤግዛም ሶሉሽን ሀብ ዩቲዩብ ቻናል ነው። እኔ መምህር ጌታ ሆን ነኝ። በዚህ ቪዲዮ የአካውንቲንግ እና ፋይናንስ ማውጫ ፈተና ኦብጀክቲቭ ጥያቄዎችን እስፔሻሊ በ2016 እና በ2015 ላይ በተሰጡ ማውጫ ፈተና ጥያቄዎችን ላይ መሰረት በማድረግ እነሱን ጥያቄዎቹን አንድ ላይ የምናየው ይሆናል። ይሄ ክፍል 3 ነው። ክፍል 1 እና ክፍል 2 ያላያችሁ በዲስክሪፕሽን ቦክስ ውስጥ ይሄን ክፍል 1 እና ክፍል 2 ቪዲዮዎችን አክሰስ የምታደርጉበት ሊንኩን አስቀምጣለሁኝ። እዛ ላይ ገብታችሁ ቪዲዮዎቹን ማየት ትችላላችሁ። ለዩቲዩብ ቻናል አዲስ ከሆናችሁ ቻናሉን ሰብስክራይብ በማድረግ የዚህ ቻናል ቤተሰብ እንድትሆኑና ሰብስክሪፕሽን ቦክስ ውስጥ ኦል በሚለው በተን ኦን በማድረግ በየጊዜው የምለቀቁ ለቪዲዮቹ ኖቲፊኬሽን እንዲደርስ እንድታደርጉላለኝ ቪዲዮን ለጓደኞቻችሁም ሼር እንድታደርጉ በቪዲዮቹ ላይ ኮሜንት እንድትጽፉና በዋናነት ቪዲዮን ስትጀምሩ ላይክ አድርጋችሁ እንድትጀምሩ ለኝ ቀጥታ ወደ ጥያቄዎች እገባለሁ። የመጀመሪያ ጥያቄ being limited has an asset with a carrying value of $30,000 and a tax base of $50,000 and the tax rate is 30%. With this specification, which of the following will be part of the balance date journal entries made to recognize tax effect accounting for this company? A. Credit deferred tax liability of $6,000. B. Debit deferred tax asset of $6,000. C. Debit income tax expense of $6,000 and D. Credit income tax liability of $6,000. So from this, which one is correct? Before deciding what the situation existing on this, we have to know either debit tax asset or debit tax liability. So we have to decide this one. So to say this here, when this tax base is greater than that of carrying amount, here we have tax base, which is given as this $50,000, and carrying value or carrying base is $30,000. And when this the tax base is greater than that of carrying amount, more taxes paid today that will be compensated in future with lower tax payment, and due to this there will be deferred tax asset. So due to this reason there will be deferred tax asset. So we have to calculate this, we have to decide whether there is deferred tax asset or deferred tax liability. So due to this, here we have given the tax base, which is $50,000, and carrying value, which is $30,000. And since this tax base is greater than that of this carrying value, there is tax deferred tax asset rather than this deferred tax liability. So what if this the tax base is this amount and the carrying value is this, there is what deferred tax liability. So after deciding this, we can calculate simply the values, the values what amount of deferred tax asset is. So to do so, first we have to know that the deductible temporary difference, as this deductible temporary difference is the difference of tax base and carrying value. So here when we take the difference of tax base and this carrying value, it is about this $20,000. So it is about $20,000, and this is the deductible temporary difference. And by using this value, we can calculate the deferred tax assets using this deductible temporary difference. And the tax rate also, we have given that the tax rate, we have tax rate of 30%. So here we have this 30% tax rate. So by using this, we can calculate that deferred tax asset, this deferred tax asset is equal with deductible temporary difference times tax rate. Here we have deductible temporary difference is $20,000 and tax rate is 30%. And when we take this value, or when we calculate for this value, the deferred tax asset is $6,000. So the deferred tax asset would be $6,000, and thus The correct answer for this question is B. This is correct answer for this question. The next question, which of the following is not the characteristics of a production process that uses process costing? A. All units are basically the same. B. All units completed are assigned the same cost. C. The units are produced in a continuous process. D. The units are produced based on customer order. So from this, which one is not characteristics or not the future of this production process that uses process costing? So here we have different characteristics or features of this process costing or production process which uses this process costing, and some of them are this here. They are usually the production process that use process costing typically exhibit this characteristics. The first one is homogeneous product. In this process, the product produces usually homogeneous, or they produce identical or similar product. And the production process which uses this process costing typically follows is continuous production. The production process is continuous. And the other is, when we say this production process which uses this process costing, they produce the product is based upon preset standards or standard production method. There is a standard production method. And the other is, they use this multiple production department or workstation. There may be multiple production departments or workstations, and there is accumulation of this cost by department. There is accumulation of cost by department, and there may be this there is uniform unit cost. So since the production is in continuous way, and the production is what the product that we are producing is identical, we fix this uniform cost for the units or for the product that we are producing. So there is uniform unit cost, and there is use of cost flows also, and there is periodic cost allocation. There is periodic cost allocation for the products. These are what the features or characteristics of this the production process which follows this process costing. So from this, from the listed one, which one doesn't show or doesn't tell features? So here, when we say this, all units are basically the same, as we have discussed, or as I have discussed, the unit is produced in this production process is identical or basically the same. They are engaged by in producing identical or the same products or units. So this is a correct feature of, or correct characteristics of this production process. The other is, all units completed are assigned the same cost. This is right also, because the units produce the cost of this the units produced in the same way is fixed in the same amount. So all units completed are assigned in the same cost. This is right. The other is, the units are produced in continuous process. This is also another feature of this production process which uses this process costing. And then the other is, the units are produced based on customer order. This is not the characteristics. So here D is correct answer. So production based on customer order is rather suitable for job order costing, because it is customer order based. D is correct answer for this question. The next, indirect tax are A, a tax whereby the impact and the incident of tax fall on the same person. B, a tax that is to be borne by the person on whom it is levied. C, a tax which cannot be passed onto others. D, tax with regressive nature. So here, when we say this indirect tax, taxes, what are they? So when we say this indirect tax, they are, this indirect tax are levies imposed on a good and service rather than directly on income or profit. And these taxes are not directly paid by the individual or entity that is legally responsible for paying the tax, but are instead passed on the consumers as part of the price of good or service. So indirect tax directly, but ያው የተፈለገው ነው የተጠየቀው ነው ታክስ ወደ ተጠቃሚ ትራንስፈር አድርገን ተጠቃሚው ነው ኮንሱመሩን እናስከፍልበት አይነት ታክስ that is what indirect tax ምንለው ያው commonly እኛ እናውቃቸው አሉ common type of this indirect tax are this sales tax value added tax or VAT ምንለው excise duties customer duties and tariffs this all are but indirect tax ምንላቸው ናቸው so these taxes are collected by business or intermediaries on behalf of the government and are usually included in the final price paid by the customer so many taxochu endet no qatta government sayon collect miyaregaw za for example hotel like one on vat misebesbo ye hotel balebet no batakalay taxu minafle tax mekefal indallebet zo productu lay or service lay ikemetna tetekamiu le hotel balab or le hotel balebet ye kefalet servisun yagegnal or product konem እንደዛው የሚያገኝበት ነው ዳይሬክትሊ መንግስት ገብቶ ሳይሆን የሚሰበስበው እዛ ላይ በሰርቪስ የሚሰጠው ኦር ፕሮዳክቱን የሚሰጥ ሰውየው እየሰበሰበ በአጠቃላይ ለመንግስት ኮሙሊቲቭሊ የሚያስረክቡበት አይነት ታክሶቹ ኢንዳይሬክት ታክስ ብለን እንጠራለን ማለት ነው ሶ ይሄን እንደዚህ ካለን there is some features of this indirect tax the first one is they are indirect in nature and the other is they are broad based and they are regressive in nature also they are regressive in nature when we say this indirect tax often have regressive impact meaning they can they take a higher proportion of income from low income and individuals compared to higher income individuals and this is because lower income individuals tend to spend a higher proportion of their income on taxable goods and services so this is what the regressive nature of that of the indirect tax and their revenue generation the other is they are simple their simplicity another they are easy of collection also when you say this indirect tax they are easy to collect for example simply we can take the example on some service on the hotel so when we want to take the or when we want to obtain the service from some hotel service or some cafeteria service directly we pay the amount that that includes that VAT for that service also so they are simple to collect and the other is ability to influence behavior also these are features some features of this indirect taxes so from this from the listed one which one best describes or describes this indirect taxes here the first one the tax whereby the impact and incident of tax fall on the same person this is wrong and the tax that is to be borne by the person on whom it is levied this may or may not be but in this case it is not directly related the other is the tax which cannot be passed onto the other this is also wrong because this indirect tax can be passed to the others the other is tax with regressive nature this is the correct answer this is the correct this is usually this indirect tax are characterized by this their regressive nature they are usually mainly characterized by their regressive nature rich and poor respective of their income qualify indirect tax and therefore are regressive in nature so after them they have ተመሳሳይ የሆነ ክፍያ ነው የሚከፍለው for example and የሆነ ቦታ ላይ juice ለመጠቀም ከሄደ somebody after them ይሆን ይችላል ድሀ ተመሳሳይ የሆነ price ነው የሚከፍለው 100 ብር ከሆነ 100 ብር 150 ብር ከሆነ 150 ብር 50 ብር ከሆነ 50 ብር ተመሳሳይ ያ ብሩ ከኢንዳይሬክት ታክስ ጋር አንድ ላይ ተጨምሮ with ምንም አይነት የሰውን ኑሮ ስታንዳርድ ሪች ኦር ፑል ኢን ኮንሲደር ሳይረክ ተመሳሳይ የሆነ ፕራይስ ነው የሚያስከፍለው ይሄ ደግሞ ወዴትኛው ኔቸር ነው የሚወዘው this regressive nature ላይ ነው የሚወዘው so when I have tried to discuss this what regressive nature means this regressive impact meaning they take higher proportion of income from low income individual compared to high income individuals so ዝቅተኛ ገቢ ያለው ሰው ከፍተኛ ገቢ ያለው ሰው ተመሳሳይ የሆነ ክፍያ ነው የሚከፍለው basically this is what the basic feature or characteristics of this indirect tax okay next cost of goods sold for a period is per 440,000 for each halal company and during that period inventory increased by per 40,000 whereas increase in account payable total per 50,000 and we are asked to calculate that cash payment to supplier that should be used in calculating cash flow from operating activities. So A, for 430,000, B, 450,000, C, 530,000, D, 350,000. So from this, what the cash payment to supplier. So to calculate this here, cash payment to supplier is equal to cost of goods sold plus increase in inventory minus decrease in inventory plus decrease in accounts payable minus increase in account payable. So these are the formula to calculate cash payment to supplier. By using this formula, we can calculate this cash payment. Therefore, here we have 440,000 plus 40,000 minus 50,000. And when we calculate for this, we obtain this 430,000 per. This is the cash payment for the supplier. So the correct answer is this per 430,000. So choice A is correct answer. Let us switch one of the following is not correct about money market instrument. A are the main source of short-term financial requirement. B are securities with maturities of 1 year, more than 1 year. C are highly liquid. D are component of financial system. So from this, which one not describes this money market instrument? Similarly here, when we say this money market instrument, they are short-term debit securities that are highly liquid and have maturities typically ranging from overnight to 1 year. And these instruments are used by governments, financial institutions, and corporations to meet short-term financial needs or to invest excess liquidity. And from this here, when we say this money market, they are main source of short-term financial requirement. This is right. It says which one of the following is not correct about money market. Are the main source of short-term financial requirement. This is right. The others are securities with maturity of more than one year. This is wrong because as I have discussed, they are instruments usually applied typically ranging from overnight to 1 year. Scandamet which I landed them at the symphonic no in minute money market instrument when the others are highly liquid, this is right, and the others are component of financial system, these all are right. But the statement at B is not wrong. The statement at B is wrong. This money market instrument are source of short-term financial requirement and highly liquid component of a financial system, rather than they are securities with maturities of more than 1 year. So this is wrong. So here we have another case. Metrov company buys raw material from outside supplier and the annual demand is 38,400 units and the annual unit carrying cost is $64. And cost of placing and receiving an order is $300. And the organization operates 240 days in a year and lead time is 2 days. And how much the cost minimizing order quantity? A, 1,200 units. B, 600 units. C, 48.5 units. D, 1,240 units. So from this, we have given parameters and we are asking to analyze or calculate the cost minimizing order quantity. So to calculate this, we have to know the given parameters. And here we have given that the annual demand, which is 38,400. And the other is we have given that the ordering cost per year, order cost per order, which is $300. And we have also given that the annual unit carrying cost, which is $64. So we are asked to analyze this economic or cost minimizing order quantity. So to do so, we can use this economic order quantity or EOQ formula, which is usually under radical 2 times this annual demand times the ordering cost per order over the annual unit carrying cost. So this is the formula to calculate that. Simply we can set this economic order quantity, this economic order quantity. So it is calculated as under radical here 2 times D times this S D times S over H, where this D is the annual demand, S is the ordering cost per order, and H is the annual holding cost per unit. So by using this formula, we can calculate this cost minimizing order quantity. And here we have given that this D is given as, this is the annual demand, which is given as this 38,400. This S is given as this 300, and H is given as here 64. So here, when we calculate for this economic order quantity, which is under radical, the demand times unit order cost divided by unit carrying cost, which is square root of this 2 times 38,400 times 300 over 64, which is 600 units. So here we have 600 units. So this is the correct answer for the question. So this 600 units. So the cost minimizing order quantity is 600. So this is the correct answer. This is the end of the part that I have on part 3 for this accounting and finance exit exam questions. So thank you for watching this video, and I will come with this part 4 of the accounting and finance exit exam questions. Don't forget to subscribe the channel, liking the video, commenting on the video, and sharing the video for your friends.